Once you finish ihram, then you take your wife home to the hotel, and then you her she should grab it, all of it up, and hold it like this, and only cut that much. That much. You grab the whole hair together and you cut that much. You cut it from up, you don't cut from down. When you're holding the hair, you cut up. Don't cut down. Okay, or you're coming back from Saudi Arabia, walking me. If you do that, once you cut her hair, she's out of ihram. You cut your hair, you're out of ihram. You can do anything you wish, and you wait for Hajj. Hajj time starts on the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah. The 8th. Okay? You go to shop, you go Mazarat, you go, oh, I forgot to tell you about Mazarat in Medina. In Medina, if you have time, they will take you the best, what you need to visit, important, is Masjid Qubat. If you visit Masjid Qubat, the Prophet ﷺ advised us to do it in Medina. They will take you there. In Medina, the Prophet ﷺ advised us to visit the graveyard of where the Battle of Uhud happened, where Hamza and the 83 Sahabi died or murdered here. He asked us to visit those two places. So visit them. Visiting Quba, you visit Quba, you make your wudu home, and you come visit Quba and pray two rak'ah there. Is like you performing Umrah. You get the reward of Umrah. Okay? The Prophet, you go to the graveyard where Hamza is being buried. It's guarded with a wall and everything. You can see through. What you say, you don't say nothing, no dua, no nothing there. You just say, Assalamu alaikum ahla diyar. Like you visit in a graveyard. That's what you do. Also, they will take you there to Masjid where the two Qibla. No prayer there. People go there and pray. No prayer there whatsoever. Unless there is Asr prayer or Dhuhr prayer, then you pray with the Imam. It's Masjid like any other Masjid. But just go there to visit historically. You see the previous Qibla, you see the Qibla where the Imam pray here? And the other Qibla, they don't put it on the floor, they put it up there. This way people, some Shia people, they pray toward it also. But that's no good. Don't pray toward this Qibla where Baytul Maqdis is. That was. But now we pray toward Al-Kaaba. Historic occasion, historic place, you visit. Other than that, nothing else you can do. Also, Al-Baqiyah, Jannatul Baqiyah. That's once you finish visiting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you come out from the door that you come out. If you just look straight to your right or to the front, you will see like guarded area. You go toward it. You don't have to go in. Usually, it's closed, open with certain time. You don't do nothing in there. All the graves looks alike. And whoever tell you this is a grave of Hadrat Aisha or this is a grave of Ibrahim, the son of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they lying to you, they don't know. But you're gonna go logically, you're gonna see all the graves like each other. They look alike. You cannot say. So once you go there, all the Sahaba buried there, some of the Sahaba buried there, the scholars, the ulama buried there, you go there or you don't go inside. From outside, you say also the dua of the graveyard. That's what you do in Al-Madinah when you visit the historic site. In Mecca also, they take you visitation. They take you to the mountain of Ghar Thawr, Ghar Hira. They take you there. People climb, and it takes 2 hours to climb, 2 hours to come back. For what? Is not ritual, is not advisable, is not the Prophet ﷺ didn't advise us to do that, so you don't do it. I want you to concentrate on Hajj. Because you might take that mountain up 2 hours. May Allah keep us all safe. And then you break your leg. Then you lost your Hajj. How did you lose your Hajj? You lost your Hajj for nothing. You cannot continue doing Hajj. You understand? So this is not recommended. So don't do it. Don't do it. If they take you there, okay, so they take you to also in Al Madinah, they take you to where the Battle of the Trench happened, and now they make it a historic site. Probably they finish it by now. Just look at it for the Prophet was here and the Mushrikeen were there, the Trench was here. Just for history. But you don't have to do it. Okay? That's where you visit in Mecca and in Medina. Now you finish Umrah. It's recommended by scholars, and the Prophet ﷺ, in his travel, he did one Umrah. Aisha during that time, radiallahu anha, Abu Aisha, she got her excuses, so she did not do Umrah with them. And when she finished, they did Hajj. And then she came, the Prophet ﷺ knew that she like kind of upset. And then he asked the companion Zubayr to take her to, I don't remember the name, I'm sorry. But he asked him to take her, of course he's a mahram, he took her to Masjid Al-Umrah, they call it. They call it the masjid there to start doing the ritual of Umrah from there. You don't have to do that. Hadrat Aisha, she did it, yes. She did it from there. But you already did one Umrah. It's okay. But Hadrat Aisha, she was coming out with Hajj and without Umrah. So the Prophet ﷺ allowed her. The scholar said, you can do. If really you don't know when you're coming back to do another Umrah and you want to do one Umrah for your father, then it's okay. One Umrah for your mother is okay. But people tend to make like windy Umrah. They keep coming, they call it Masjid Aisha because Aisha wanted to start Umrah from there. That's unacceptable, not permissible. You don't do that. If you want to do one more Umrah, two more Umrah, it's okay. But I mean, 100 Umrah, you will be tired, you will be restless. When Hajj comes, you won't do the Hajj ritual as you're supposed to do. So, which is no good. So, the scholar recommended that you do one Umrah in your travel and the Hajj. You want to do another Umrah, come back and do another Umrah. Okay, that's the most recommended thing. Anything in the Umrah part? Any question? Yes. Stop tawaf and you pray. And after you stop where you are. And after you do prayer, you start from where you left tawaf. Same thing, Safa and Marwa. Yes. You stop and do that. Yes. We're going to start on Hajj now, inshallah. How many of people traveling before next Sunday? Next Sunday. You leaving before next Sunday? Who's traveling before next Sunday, Sheikh Bash? Okay, already. So the rest of you staying until next Sunday? So you want to do another session on Sunday? Okay, inshallah. We're going to repeat Hajj alone next Sunday, inshallah. For people who will attend. But now, because people that are traveling, we will tell them how to perform Hajj also, inshallah. Okay, yes. Oh, of course. Gonna do that. What's that, brother? Drinking of Zamzam water. Okay, that's a good part. I passed that part. Once you finish praying after Ibrahim's station, once you finish, and you go to do Sa'i, Safa and Marwa, There is now Punjil. It used to be this black area here, you see. It used to be Zamzam downstairs. You go down, now they block it. They change it. Now Zamzam, they have it in containers around the whole hub. What you do is you go to Zamzam, from any container, you drink as much as you can. You drink until you feel that Zamzam water gonna come out of your eyes. And you drink and you make dua. Oh Allah, please give me shufa. Oh Allah, please give me knowledge. Oh Allah, please let me drink from the Prophet's hand in the Day of Judgment. You make dua after. That's after you pray the two rak'ah after the tawaf, before you go to as-sa'i. And of course, Zamzam, you drink Zamzam all you can. Every day, every night, you can carry Zamzam with you to the hotel and you drink from that. Yes. Thank you for reminding. For what? Is what? Stitches? It's okay, no. Okay, inshallah. The brother asking about he's wearing a sandal with a stitches. It's okay. You can do it. I prefer that you wear a plastic, good plastic sandals. You bring, because some said no, you cannot. But I mean, if you wear it, it's fine. Inshallah. Yes, it's okay. Inshallah. Yes, who else? Finish. I'm not coming back to you, Min. Yes, brother. Okay. That's for non-Hajji.
Yeah.
If you are not a Hajji, during Eid time, we call the sacrifice Eid. You pray with the Imam and you go out and after you pray, you go and slaughter your animal. And you, if you intend to sacrifice the animal on Eid day, so during the 10th day of Dhul-Hijjah, from the beginning to after you sacrifice, you resemble Hajji, like how you are in a status, kind of status of Ihram. You don't cut your nail, you don't pull your hair, you don't do such a thing like that. That's good. But of course you can have relationship with your wife is fine, because you are not Hajji. You are not Hajji. But you're resembling. You say, oh Allah, Hajji is not doing this, not doing that. I'm doing part of that. Yes, you do that. Okay?
In
Al-Hajj, no. In Al-Hajj, you don't fast unless you don't have money. Or you don't have, you don't have to. I mean, if you cannot afford to slaughter the animal, then you fast. Other than that, no fasting in Hajj. But non-Hajji, Arafat day, they fast. And the Prophet said, if you fast Arafat day, Allah will forgive you two consecutive years. One of them, fast here and one present. But during Hajj, you don't fast. It's not allowed. Because you need to keep your strength. You fast Arafah day, you cannot go to Muzdalifah, you lose Hajj. You fast Arafah day and you cannot complete your ritual, then you lose Hajj. You understand? Okay. Jazakallah khair. Yes, brother. Sister, inshallah, prepare your question. And during Hajj question, you will be first to ask, remind me. And they will be second. You can go silent and you can make dua. Yes, we said that. You remember when I said the first dua you make is for Jetta?
Yes,
sir. Is it?
What
would you say? Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. You're not saying no more. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. You stop saying it when you see the Ka'bah. After that, no more. That's it. Yes. That's it. You don't say it no more. Yes, my brother. Instead of what? Yes, you can use rope, no problem. Yes, you can use rope, sorry. Every time, not two hands, brother. One hand. I really don't recommend safety pins because they have a lot of problems. And you don't have to use them. As I said, the towel or the cloth is very long enough to put in the I don't advise using it. Scholars said don't use it. Some of them said yes. If you can do without it, it's fine. Okay. Yeah, don't do it then. Your sister, inshallah. You have the microphone, you can ask. Any question? Yes. Now throwing the stone is as easy as can be. You can do it. No crowd and no hassles around it is easy. So try to remind yourself. Then you can take with you hold it in your left hand and you take it and throw it with your right hand. Will be good practicing with the right hand. But if you cannot, like if you throw it, you always use your right hand. If you throw it with your left hand, it will be hassle for you or unsafe, and you need, instead of 7 pebbles, you need 100 pebbles to get them inside there, then it's okay. But better to practice with you. So, yeah. Question?
The dua you were saying, Allahumma mahilli haitu habastani, can you explain one more time when and how to recite that one?
Okay, Allahumma, everybody say, Allahumma mahilli haithu habastani. Allahumma mahilli haithu habastani. Allahumma mahilli haithu habastani. And the benefit of this dua, if any incident happened to you and you want to discontinue your ihram or you want to stop your umrah or your hajj, you can do it without any penalty and get out of it as easy as saying that word. If you do not say and any incident happened, you want to stop ihram, or you want to get out of ihram, then you have to slaughter an animal. You have to come back from the same time, the same day that you lost your ihram in, and a lot of hassle. Okay, so you better say it, inshallah.
So you're saying, labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, and I continue the dua with it?
I'm sorry, again, sister.
The labbaik, when I'm reciting the labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, I'm reciting this dua with it?
No. What we said is you wear your, you take your shower, you clean yourself, you take your shower, you wear your ihram, and if there is a prayer time, then you pray. If there is no prayer time and you went to the masjid, pray tahiyatul masjid and initiate your ihram by saying labbaik Allahumma umrah. You say labbaik Allahumma umrah. Or labbaik Allahumma hajj. Why? After you finish praying. Once you said that, right away after it, you said Allahumma mahilli haythu habastani. And you remember we said you start labbaik Allahumma labbaik when you're riding your camel or your plane or your bus. You say labbaik Allahumma. Clear? Good enough. Any questions? Sister, if you have a private question, special question, before I leave, inshallah, I can come and answer it for you. Also, if you, if we left, didn't answer your question, take my phone number down, 469-682-1-1-1. 8, 8, 9. Again, 4, 6, 9, 6, 8, 2, 1, 8, 8, 9. That phone number is only for you. Don't give it to the FBI guys. They already have it. Huh? Oh yes, I do. Wanna write it down? A B O. A B as in boy. O E S as in Sam. H A Q gmail.com. A B O E S H A Q at gmail. So any question you could send it, or you could call me, inshallah, I will answer your question, inshallah. From now until next week, also prepare your question, write them down, and come back, and we will answer your question to the best of my knowledge. Of course you can scratch, you can take a shower, but not scratching with pulling. Scratch have nothing to do with it. Yeah, you scratch. You scratch, but you do not kill a fly, you do not kill a mosquito, or you do not kill anything. You don't do that during ihram. Okay, start Hajj.
Yes.
Can we start Hajj? Okay. Now, after we finish Umrah, you're gonna enjoy your time. Depend on your group. Depend on your travel agent. How many days you staying in Mecca? How many days you staying in Medina to come back? But the main thing is when you come back, inshallah, you're going to start Hajj from the 8th of Dhul Hijjah. 8th of Dhul Hijjah, what you do is you're going to repeat the ihram steps. You're going to do it in your hotel. Now it's easy, not riding a plane or anything. You're going to take a shower, you clean yourself, you take a shower in your hotel. Of course, your travel agent will tell you, okay, we're going to move to Arafat in the morning and the afternoon. Just cooperate with them. And whenever they said, you agree with them and you be ready. So whichever time, what you do is you clean yourself, you take your shower in your hotel with ihram niyya, ihram for Hajj. And then what you do is, you wear your garment, you wear your two cloth, one on the top and one on the bottom, and the sister wear her complete clothes with hijab, of course, and as I said, with very comfortable shoes. Also, I forgot to tell you, during ihram, for us, it's good practice, which I do, 99-cent store, you go buy Vaseline, you know Vaseline? Medical Vaseline? Because over there it's too hot. And the heat and the sweat, it will make inflammation here between the two legs. And if you get that, that's the most miserable thing you will ever get. You will hate yourself. So what you do is, what I say to my brothers and sisters, before you wear your ihram, grease yourself. You know the car, you take the car to the mechanic and grease the car to maintain it. I want you to do that to yourself. You just get that Vaseline and put it between your legs, those two parts, because the sweat, when it's dry, the salt will be there. And then you walk your leg. It doesn't mean that you're fat or anything, no, I'm not saying that, but sometimes your leg will touch, and then if it touch with the salt, then it gets inflamed, and then get hunger, and then when you do that, it will hurt. So what you do is, you get that Vaseline, no scent Vaseline, and you use it. That will be a good practice, and inshallah, you will thank me when you come back. And if you ever get that, take from here also, like with Muhammad, you take antifungal cream with you. If you get the inflammation, if you get this inflammation, don't put Vaseline. Don't put Vaseline. What you do is you use the antifungal cream. They have it there also. You ask them, they will give it to you. Okay? Yeah. On the 8th, at your hotel, you make the intention for Hajj. You could go to Mecca, to Al-Haram, and you pray with them. Pray, if they say, okay, we will meet in the hotel, Asr time, to after Asr, to go to Arafat, as early as Asr time. Then you go pray Asr, and after praying Asr, you make the intention in Al-Haram. After Asr prayer, okay? What? You made the intention for Hajj. لبيك اللهم حج. In the beginning, we did not mention Hajj combined or Hajj tamattu or Hajj by itself or the Umrah was Hajj. We didn't mention that. We said plain Umrah, right? Now there is three types of Hajj. One of them and the most important one, and that's what you will do, called Hajj tamattu. Enjoyment Hajj. Before you do your Umrah, what you will do, write this down also. You're going to say, لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ عُمْرَةً, right? With enjoyment until Hajj. You're going to do that. لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ عُمْرَةً مُتَمَتِّعًا بِهَا إِلَى الْحَجِّ. You understand? That's the intention you will do. لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ عُمْرَةً with enjoyment till Hajj. Okay? That's called Hajj Tamattu. We're going to explain that inshallah. And that's why in Hajj Tamattu we spend the time between Umrah and Hajj we enjoy. What do you mean we enjoy? We wear our regular clothes. If you have your wife, then you can have relationship with her. There is no problem. The complete enjoyment. Complete normal individual living. That's what you do. That's you pay for it. You slaughter an animal. Say, Allah, because you allow me to do that, this is an animal. Slaughter. That's what you pay for. That enjoyment. Okay? There is another Hajj you only do Hajj alone. لبيك اللهم حج. You do tawaf for Hajj, sa'i for Hajj. You do tawaf. When you do that called Hajj mufrad, you don't slaughter animals. You don't slaughter animals, but you do it only Hajj. Whether you start from now or the 8th of the Hijjah, you're going to do it, you're going to stay in Ihram. You cannot take off your Ihram. There is another Hajj called Hajj Qaran, combined Hajj. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, دخلت العمرة في الحج, دخلت العمرة في الحج. That Hajj involving Umrah. And Umrah is inside Hajj. Like you do, every step you do, it will consider for Umrah and Hajj. In Hajj Quran also you slaughter an animal. Why? The scholar said because you do it one step or both. For Umrah and Hajj. You do it tawaf for Umrah and Hajj. You do it sa'i for Umrah and Hajj. Then that's what you do. You pay for it. Also, it's kind of easiness. Okay? What we're doing is Hajj Tamattu. Is the Prophet ﷺ advised his companion to do Hajj Tamattu, enjoyment Hajj. And he said, if Allah keep me alive till next year, I will do enjoyment Hajj. That's the Prophet said that. The Prophet ﷺ did Hajj Mufrad. Yes. Yes. No. No. Hajj, I come. He did Quran because he saq al Hajj sallallahu alayhi wa He did Quran saq al With Hajj Quran, they say you have to, the good scholars say that you have to drive your animal which you go into slaughter from the place you are from. So if you want to do Hajj Quran, then you have to take your sheep from here. Then yes. Or you buy from Jeddah and then you take it with you. That's Hajj Quran. And the Prophet ﷺ said, if Allah gave me or keep me until next year or another Hajj, then I will do tamam. I will make enjoyment Hajj. Okay? So that's what we do. So with Umrah, we say لبيك اللهم عمرة متمتعا بها إلى الحج. لبيك اللهم عمرة with enjoyment till إيه؟ until Hajj. Now, you during the Hajj niyyah, you say لبيك اللهم حج. لبيك اللهم حج. Oh Allah, please accept it from me. And you say the dua also, اللهم محلي حيث حبستني. You said it. And then you go with your group to Mina. You're gonna go to Mina. And going to Mina, whether you went early in the morning or late at night, depending on the time you go with your group, depending on the traffic, you pray there dhuhr 2 rak'ah by itself, and asr 2 rak'ah by itself, maghrib 3 rak'ah by itself, and isha 2 rak'ah by itself. And don't forget to pray witr 1 rak'ah or 3 rak'ah, because the Prophet ﷺ never left witr or the sunnah of fajr. He always prayed them. You pray with them in jama'ah, jama'ah will be there, you pray with them inshallah, you pray with them. So that each day you will pray all the prayer, 5 prayers there, depending on the time you go there, each one by itself, but short and no combination. You don't combine. Okay? Not yet. We are on 8th of Dhul Hijjah, Sheikh Bakr. Okay. You are not a normal individual. I don't mean by abnormal that you're crazy or you're sick, but no. But you are not, if you are not, you are hajji.